Hello and welcome, welcome, welcome. We're excited about this program today. It is Sunday morning. Come on, rise and shine and let's get ready to worship God. Donna McClurkin is getting ready to take us into the presence of God. Amen. And we're getting ready to hear what thus saith the Lord today. I'm Bishop Van Sharp. I'm the pastor and I'm the founder of Newness of Life Christian Center. One of, not the only, but one of the greatest churches in the world today. And I thank God that NOLCC, I know you're out there today. I'm going to send a big shout out to you on behalf of my lovely wife, Reese, and I. A shout out to NOLCC. I want you to get on that phone. I want you to text somebody, email somebody, and let them know, amen, that Newness of Life Christian Center is on the air. And each and every Sunday morning, until this shutdown is over, until, amen, we go back into the local sanctuary, we'll be right here sharing the word of God with you. I just want you to get excited today. The Bible says in Psalms 18 and verse number 3, listen at Psalms 18 and 3, it says, I will call upon the Lord who is worthy to be praised. So shall I be saved from mine enemies. Let me say this to you. With all that's going on in our world today, we see so much, amen. Of course, we're dealing with this injustice that is has taken place, amen, in the case of George Floyd, as well as the injustice that took place, amen, years ago. We're looking at Trayvon Martin. We're looking at Eric Garner, who also says, I can't breathe. Amen. And others, amen, like Freddie Gray and other situations that we're looking at, Tamar Rice, and of course, Rodney King situation. Amen. But in the midst of it all, we need to call upon the Lord, because when we call upon the Lord, there's deliverance from God. And of course, we need to speak out. In fact, on this past Thursday, if you go back on Facebook Live and look at the program, as well as on YouTube, you can pull up a program, amen, entitled, What Does It Take to Shake You Up? In that particular program, I talk about two books that deal with racism, one called Free at Last by Apostle Michael Goins, as well as Black History Through Blue Eyes, the subtitle, The Debt the World Owes to Africa by Dr. James Seymour. Want to challenge you to get that, as well as the book entitled, I Am My Brother's Keeper. This is a book written by myself. We've written 10 books, and this book is indeed a powerful book. It's titled, I Am My Brother's Keeper, Empowering Men to Take Their Place. And it's some tremendous stuff that can help you grow in the Lord. Amen. But right now, we're getting ready to worship God. Once you get excited, amen, as Donna McClurkin is singing this song, amen, talking about calling upon the Lord. Again, Psalms 18 and verse number 3 says, I will call upon the Lord who is worthy to be praised. So shall I be saved from mine enemies. The Lord liveth, and blessed be the rock, and blessed the God of my salvation be exalted. Amen. So I want you to get ready to worship God. Get ready to call upon the Lord. Get ready to worship him like you never worshiped him before. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Come on, worshipers. It's Sunday morning. It's time to worship. It's time to exalt the name that is above every name, and that is the name of Jesus. Oh. Come on, put your oh in there. Oh. Bless you, Brother Wayne White is watching me this morning. Bless you, Brother Wayne, as well as your lovely wife, amen, Patricia. Hope she's watching with you. Joyce Harris is watching me this morning. All right, Joyce. LaDoris Leonard is watching. Praise God. As well as Tanya Gillette is watching.
Hey, Tanya. Praise God, Tanya.
Shout out to you from Lisa and I. We love you. Hallelujah. Again, shout out to NOLCC. Oh, The Lord liveth. Come on, worshipers. Throw your hands up and start worshiping God. Because great things happen when we call on the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. You gotta call on it. The nation of Israel called on God, and God delivered them from the hand of Pharaoh. And in this time of racial injustices, we need to be calling on the name of the Lord, that the Lord might turn it around for us. Shout out to Mother Evangeline Whitaker. Amen. Shout out to Adwella's son, K. Moses. All right now. Hallelujah. Amen. You just celebrated a birthday again. Happy birthday, Shantae. The Lord liveth, and blessed be the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes. Put those hands together. Worship Him. Donna McClurkin. Awesome singer. Awesome worshiper. There's only one God. There's only one God. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one God. He's Lord over my life. Is He Lord over your life? Bless you, Brother Vincent Bellamy. Shout there, man. Dance there. Wave your hands and praise Him. Hallelujah. There's only one God. Nobody like Jehovah. Woo! He's the one that can bring you out of anything, turn it around for you, make it work in your favor. Come on, worshipers. He's Lord over my life. Bless you also, Evangelist Jackie Bellamy. Amen. As well as Bishop Ronald Wayne Sharp, Pastor Marguerite Sharp, and my nephew Jonathan Sharp. Shout out to all three of you. Hallelujah. Give Him praise this morning. It's Sunday morning. Time to wake up and give God the glory. For we know that He's worthy to be praised. There's only one God. Shout out to my daughter, Vanika Sharp, as well as my grandchildren, Amen, Caden, Adalen, and Casey. There's only one God. Hallelujah. Jesus is His name. Come on. We're praising the Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Glory to God. Hallelujah. Amen. That's Donna McClurkin shouting out, singing that song, Amen, from Psalms 18 and verse 3. I will call upon the Lord, who is worthy to be praised. So shall I be saved from mine enemies. We must recognize that no man, white, black, Hispanic, or any other color, is greater than the God we serve. And the nation of Israel were delivered from the hand of Pharaoh because they cried out to God. And when they cried out to God, God said, I am come down to deliver you from the hand of Pharaoh. And God raised up Moses. And I believe that God is raising up his church to shout, to lift up our voice against racial prejudice, against racial injustices, against all these kinds of things that have held people in bondage and held people back for centuries. We have to speak up. We have to speak out. We have to let our voices be heard in this time. We recognize, amen, that in Christ, there's no male, there's not female. In Christ, there's no Jew, there's no Greek, but we are one in the Lord. And those of us who are in Christ, we owe it to God. We owe it to people around us to speak the word. Of course, I'm a black man. Amen. And as a black man, when you see those kinds of things, you can't help but grieve. You can't help but hurt. But we recognize, amen, there's a way to deal with it. And that's calling upon the Lord. And that's speaking up. And that's voting. You got to vote. Amen. That's why we vote and get people, get the wrong people out and put the right people in. I'm going to share with you, there's a scripture in the book of Proverbs that says, righteousness exalteth a nation, but sin is a reproach to any people. The Bible also says that when the righteous are in authority, the city and the people, they rejoice. But when the wicked bear rule, then the city and the people, they mourn. And a lot of mourning is going on in America and in our country because we got wicked people in place. But through voting, and I pray and I hope that we will always exercise our right to vote. I pray that you will always vote, amen, not just for president, but I'm talking about your local officials, your governors, your mayors, amen, your senators, that we will exercise our right to vote, because it's through voting, getting the righteous people in there, policies and other things can change and shift and thereby help, amen, make things better for everybody. We're not just talking about making things better for black people. Of course, we know that we have been put aside in a lot of ways and pushed aside in a lot of ways. Therefore, we have to stand up and speak. And when people say, amen, black lives matter, we're not saying white lives don't matter or Hispanic lives don't matter. That is saying to the nation and trying to tell the world that, hey, don't just try to hang us. Don't just try to shoot us down. Don't just try to do things that hinder our success and hinder our prosperity while you, on the other hand, prosper in a big way. We are against white supremacy. We are against anybody who's trying to exalt themselves above another race due to the color of their skin. But anyway, let's get into this. We're going to have a word of prayer, go into the word of God as we talk to you about part three of a message entitled The World System versus the Kingdom of God System. Don't forget, if you missed that message this past Thursday night, what we talked about, we're going to pick up right there this upcoming Thursday, because each and every Thursday we are on the air right here on Facebook Live, rather, each and every Thursday night at 7 o'clock on Sharp Points. Now, each and every Tuesday night you can watch us here. Amen. Our Bible study is here each and every Tuesday night. Amen. On Facebook Live. And you can also, if you miss those programs, you can go back and check them out on YouTube. Amen. At 7:30 each and every Tuesday night. Amen. And then I'm telling you, amen, I have a natural brother who's a spiritual brother to me, Bishop Ronald Wayne Sharp. He has a program that's going to be coming up, amen, at 11:15 on this Facebook Live. And so I challenge you to tune in. He also comes on every Wednesday night. Amen. Bless you, Sister Sabrina Williams. Good to know you're watching us. Amen. A powerful woman of God, skilled, can sing, can play instruments, part of Powerhouse Church of Jesus Christ. Her pastor is Bishop Ronald Wayne and Marjorie Sharp. And bless you, Sylvia Moore. Good to know you're watching us today. And I hope you're going to be blessed and know you're going to be blessed by the word of God. All right. Amen. Let's get ready to have a word of prayer right now. Father, thank you for revelation, knowledge, and wisdom flowing through my lips. I thank you that you will think through my mind, speak through my lips, a relevant life-changing word that will elevate us in the kingdom of God. We give you glory, honor, and praise in Jesus' name. Amen, amen. Bless you, Minister Sherlene Thomas. Good to hear from you. Amen. Great woman of God. Amen. Have a great leader there in the person of Apostle Margot Garner. We love you and we thank God that you tune in and hope all is well with you and that great ministry there. All right. Let us get our Bibles out now. And I need you to get your Bible out, your iPhone out. And y'all know how we do every Sunday morning. We don't do it on Bible study. We don't do it on Sharpen. We do it every Sunday. And anytime that I go and preach the word, I always like people to raise their Bible up, put their Bible up, put it in the devil's face and make a bold statement and say, this is my Bible. Come on, say that with me. This is my Bible. I am who this book says that I am. I can do what this book says I can do. And I can have what this book says I can have. And today, come on, say that with me. Today, right now, my life shall change. I'll never ever, come on, say it. I'll never ever be the same in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. All right. Bless you, Veronica Nichols there in Durham, North Carolina. Hope you and your wonderful husband and that little great little man of God, that little boy of yours, amen, Michael, are doing great. Amen. All right. Let's look at this. We're going to get into it as quickly and move into some things that are deep and rich and going to help us. We are talking to you about how that God is a God of increase. Psalms 115 verses 14 and 15 reads as follows. The Lord shall, not he might, he may not, the Lord shall increase you more and more, you and your children. Ye are not trying to be blessed. Ye are blessed of the Lord, which made heaven and earth. Those of us who are in Christ, who are in the kingdom of God, we are a blessed people. And we should expect God to bring increase to us. We should not expect decrease. We should expect God to bring increase. However, we know that we have to understand systems, that before we came to Christ, we were in the world's system. Now that we're in Christ, we're in the kingdom of God system. Now we said to you that a system is a way of doing things or a way things operate, function, and are governed. Let me say it again. A system is a way of doing things or a way that things operate, function, and are governed. A system is a form of government or control. When a system is set up, it governs things and it controls things. We have indeed a prison system. It is a form or a control over things. You have an educational system. But here, all of it is either in the world system or in the kingdom of God system. Those of us who are saved, who are born again, when we bring the message to people, we bring the message of the kingdom of God. God's rule, God's reign, God's control is at hand. So we understand that Jesus spoke profoundly to us in John 18 and 36. John 18 and 36, the Bible said, Jesus answered, my kingdom is not of this world. If my kingdom were of this world, then would my servants fight that I should not be delivered to the Jews, but now is my kingdom not from hence. So Jesus talked about his kingdom, and he said his kingdom was not of the world's kingdom. So he's talking about two different kingdoms, two different systems, the world system and the kingdom of God system. All right, Colossians 1, verses 12 and 13, it says, giving thanks unto the Father, which hath made us meet or fit to be partakers of the inheritance in light. Listen at what it says. Who hath delivered us from the power. That word power there is not dunamis. That word power there is exousia. Or as some people say, exousia. It's spelled E-X-O-U-S-I-A. And it means authority. It means jurisdiction. So we understand that God has delivered us from the jurisdiction, from the authority of darkness and has translated us into the kingdom of his dear son. So you and I who are saved, we have been translated from the jurisdiction, from the authority of the devil, from the authority of darkness, and we've been brought into the kingdom of God. Now, we said the world system is controlled by fear, doubt, and unbelief. It's controlled by what? Fear, doubt, and unbelief. The kingdom of God system is controlled by perfect love, faith, and believing. Perfect love, faith, and believing. That's how the kingdom of God system is controlled. We said that the world system is always trying to change our name. Bless you. Amen. Wayne Evans Jr. Woo! Oh my God. A shout out to him. Amen. One of our college friends that we love dearly. So good to hear from you, sir. Amen. We love you, man. You got to catch up with our writing. We've written 10 books now. Amen. You got to get them all, man. I know you got a few of them years ago. You got to get the rest of them. Amen. In fact, we have several more in the oven. Amen. And some are at the publisher's desk right now. Going to be out soon. Amen. We're excited about him. A singing young man, a man that we love dearly, Wayne Evans. Amen. He's from Delaware. Amen. Good to hear from you, man. All right. Now, let's look at this thing. The kingdom of God system, again, amen, is controlled by what? Perfect love. What else? Faith and believing. That's why the Bible said the just shall live by his faith. We're in another system. We've been brought out of the world system to live in the kingdom of God system. Now, the world system is always trying to change our name and make us therefore believe that we are, amen, of people that are undignified, that we are people that are should be involved in foolishness and things that kill ourselves. Amen. We see that in the book of Daniel, that they change Daniel's name, they change Hananiah's name, they change Azariah's name, they change Mishael's name, they change it to Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Change their name because the devil is always trying to change our name. Amen. To something foolish, something corrupt. And they also want to change our diet. They change their diet, wanted them to change their diet. But Daniel and the Hebrew boys refused to change their diet. They decided we're going to eat, amen, what we've been eating, what we know to be healthy. And they came out looking good. They came out looking whole. They came out looking better than those who were in and partaking rather of that king's meat. And of course they changed their music, want them to bow down to that image. The world system will always corrupt you through what? A name, through a diet, or also through music. That's how the world system corrupt man. Amen. With filthy, corrupt music, with nasty and ugly lyrics that causes men, amen, to lust, to do evil, to shoot, to kill, to do those things that are deadly. But we are in God's system. Now, the world system in the Bible, when you see the word world, of course, it can mean several things. But basically, when you see it as we're talking about, it is the Greek word cosmos, K-O-S-M-O-S. And that means a decoration, an arrangement, an order of things, or an adornment. Is where we get the English word cosmetics from. You know, cosmetics spell, amen, C-O-S, amen. But this right here is spelled K-O-S-M-O-S. So cosmetic or, amen, cosmetology, amen. They are what? Decorating you. They're arranging you. They're putting your face in order and everything else. Amen. You know women, amen, put on their lipstick, their makeup and earrings and jewelry to what? Decorate themselves, to arrange themselves, to bring themselves in order. Well, the world system is an order and arrangement, amen, and it is the whole circle of earthly goods, riches, advantages, and pleasures that will seduce men away from God. So there's a system, there's an order, there's an arrangement of things that are set up to seduce men away from God. When I say men, I'm talking about male and female. There's an order. There's earthly goods. There's earthly pleasures that Satan has set up to seduce men away from God. It is the whole mass of men, male and female, who are alienated from God and who are hostile to the cause of Christ. So there's a system that makes you fight and war against the church and against God. There's a whole system set up to make men not want to go to the house of God, make men not want to pray, make men not want to live for God. That is a system, an order of pleasure, of drinking, of partying, of, amen, participating in wickedness that causes men and women that when you and I meet them and witness to them and tell them about the goodness of God and tell them about serving God, what do they say? Man, I ain't got time for that. I don't want to hear nothing about that. Why? They are seduced by a system, by an order, by an arrangement set up by the wicked one to destroy them. Now look at what the Bible said in Hebrews chapter 11, verses 24 and 25. You'll see it here. The Bible said, by faith, Moses, when he was come to years, refused to be called the son of Pharaoh's daughter. Verse 25, choosing rather to suffer the affliction with the people of God than to enjoy the pleasures of sin for a season. So he had to make a choice to either stay in a system where the pleasures of sin could be enjoyed, or to get out of that system and work with God's people and help deliver God's people. Well, Moses chose to work with God's people and leave the pleasures of sin and the prosperity of the wicked and all that behind. Think about it. Moses could have stayed in the house of Pharaoh and been raised up there and had riches and honor and everything else, but he got out of that system, walked away from that system, and got to working with God's people. You and I have to do the same. Get out of that wicked system where prejudice is, where hate is, where jealousy is, where corruption is. We come out of that system and get over into the kingdom of God system. This is Hebrews 11, 24 and 25. If I'm seeming to go too fast, look on the screen and you will see those scriptures that I'm giving you. John 3, verses 19, 20 and 21. John 3, 19, 20 and 21. Listen at what it says. And this is the condemnation, that light is coming to the world. What is the condemnation? That light is in the world, and men loved darkness rather than light, because their deeds were evil. For everyone that doeth evil hateth the light, neither cometh to the light, lest his deeds should be reproved. But he that doeth truth cometh to the light, that his deeds may be made manifest, that they are wrought in God. So you and I, we came out of darkness into the marvelous light. But he tells us why some people, in spite of hearing preaching, in spite of churches being on almost every corner, why they still prefer the clubs, why they still prefer drinking Michelob Light, why they still prefer, amen, living for the enemy, is because men love darkness rather than light. They call darkness fun. But we need to let men know that the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life, and that there is a pleasure in God that exceeds the pleasure of the world. Hallelujah. So we need to understand this. Now, let me say this to you. I'm going to do this quick review real quick. We talked about the world system. We said that it is under the control of Satan or the devil. Number two, it is a corrupt system. It's based on unrighteousness, and it is an ungodly and a wicked system. Number three, it is controlled or governed by lust or greed. There's those three things you got to get. It is under the control of Satan or the devil. It is a corrupt system. It's based on unrighteousness. It is an ungodly and wicked system. And it's controlled or governed by lust or greed. All of that is under there. You can see it on your screen there. Now, what is contained in this system? Or what does this system or the world system, the cosmos, consist of? Number one, it consists of wicked or corrupt angels. Remember, Lucifer means light bearer or bearer of light, according to Isaiah 14 and 12. This angel was a bearer of light, but Lucifer was one that rebelled against God, and he became wicked and he became corrupt, and therefore he's no longer a man, a light bearer or bearer of light. He now disguises himself as an angel of light. He's not an angel of light. He's an angel of darkness. He's an angel of wickedness. He's an angel of corruption. But he has to disguise himself as an angel of light. Number two, amen. What's in this world system is wicked and corrupt people. Wicked and corrupt people. The Bible says in Psalms 12 and verse number 8, Psalm 12 and verse number 8 said, the wicked walk on every side when the vilest men are exalted. So the wicked walk on every side when you exalt vile men. That's why it was imperative that these policemen be charged for this wicked crime. Anytime you got your knee on a man's neck, the man saying, I can't breathe. The man saying, you're going to kill me. The man crying out for his mama. The man saying goodbye to his family. And yet you have your foot, I mean, have your knee on his neck for almost 9 minutes. You have your knee on this man's neck for over 8 minutes. And then, amen, the last over 2.5 minutes, and 2 minutes and 53 seconds to be exact, this man is not even responsive. And you keep your knee on this man's neck for 2 minutes and 53 seconds where he's not even responsive. And not only do you do that, you have these other men holding his legs down and nobody pushes you off. Nobody does anything. Amen. That is wickedness. And that's what's in the world system. Wicked and corrupt people are in the world system. Number three, wicked and corrupt power. That's what we're seeing. Wicked and corrupt power. Because we ought to have been black and we ought to have our knee on a white man's neck, we have been in jail. Not yesterday, but my God, we would have been in jail, amen, the moment it happened. We would have been right there behind bars. And let me tell you something. We wouldn't have been on no $500,000 bond. We would have been on a bond so high, there's no way our family could have got us out there. Are you hearing what I'm saying? But this man is able to be, got the get out, and is at home with his family and friends, amen, because his bond was only $500,000, which means he only had to pay $5,000 and he's home, and you know he's home, and the other ones have not even been charged with anything. That's what? Wicked power. That's what's under that world system. Number four, wicked and corrupt wisdom. Now, they're going to try to explain this stuff away, and that's why I agree with Mayor Bottoms, who's the mayor of Atlanta. I agree with her, amen, totally, amen, that it we who are out there and we are burning buildings and looting, this is total chaos. I agree with her when she said that, amen, this is not protest. This is not what Martin Luther King was about. Martin Luther King Jr. is about is chaos. I agree with what Mayor Bottom said. Thank God for that brave black woman who stood up and called it for what it is. We are not, amen, going along with that kind of protest. We believe in protesting in a wholesome way, in a way that we get our point across and heard, amen, in a peaceful protest, not a violent one, burning down buildings, burning down black businesses, looting Starbucks, all that kind of stuff, amen, that is, again, wicked and corrupt wisdom. It won't get us heard, and it, amen, moves the narrative and shifts the narrative from what it should be. In Raleigh, North Carolina, what they're doing, burning stuff is wrong, looting stuff is wrong. In Greensboro, amen, in Fayetteville, amen, we don't have to and should not handle it that way. We're going to talk about the kingdom of God system, amen. Again, it's wicked and corrupt angels, wicked and corrupt people, wicked and corrupt power, wicked and corrupt wisdom, wicked and corrupt money and prosperity. There is wicked and corrupt money and wicked and corrupt prosperity in that system. Many people have made money through wicked and corrupt power and wicked and corrupt wisdom. And they got wicked and corrupt money. For example, like selling drugs. That's part of that world system. Selling wine. Wicked and corrupt system. ABC store. They never shut down during this whole pandemic. They ain't been shut down. That's what? Wicked and corrupt prosperity. We don't want to work in places like that. Why? It's wicked and corrupt prosperity. That's what is called in the Bible the prosperity of the wicked. When you make money off selling us music that causes us to curse and call women ugly names, calling them the B word and other things, that's wicked and corrupt money. Number six, wicked and corrupt success. You and I have to recognize there is wicked and corrupt success. That's why we don't envy the wicked. That's why David tells us, do not envy the wicked, for they will soon be cut down like grass. Why? He's telling you, don't envy their prosperity. Don't envy the kind of car they drive, the kind of house they live in, the kind of money they got. Why? Because if you do, it will lead you away from God. He's telling you, watch the way they end up. They're going to be cut down like the grass, mowed down like the grass. We only look at those who are serving God, who are honoring God, who are walking upright. Amen. See, we don't envy the prosperity that people got. Amen. These rappers and stuff got. And these people that are out there selling their vodka drinks, selling their wine, toasting their champagne. Amen. All this stuff. No, you don't envy that at all. Because why? You recognize that's corrupt prosperity. And it will be mowed down. Amen. Because Satan is setting them up for the kill. All right. Now listen. You cannot change this demonic and wicked system or culture. You don't change it. What you do is come out of it. What you do is bring your mind out of it. Bring your heart out of it. And bring your lifestyle out of it. And come on into the kingdom of God. And we're going to talk to you about that. Listen at Romans 12 and 2 in the Message translation. Romans chapter 12 and verse number 2 in the Message translation. We know what the King James Version says. It tells us how that we are to not be conformed to this world, be transformed by the renewing of our mind, that we may prove what is the good, acceptable, and perfect will of God. That's the King James Version of it. But here's what the Message Bible said. So here's what I want you to do. God helping you. Take your everyday, ordinary life, your sleeping, eating, going to work, and walking around life, and place it before God as an offering. Embracing what God does for you is the best thing you can do for him. No, we got to embrace what God is doing for us. And in this hour, God is trying to tell us this is our more season, that he wants to bless us spiritually with more and naturally with more. Listen to what he says. Don't become so well adjusted to your culture that you fit into it without even thinking. Instead, fix your attention on God. You will be changed from the inside out, readily recognizing what he wants from you and quickly respond to it. Unlike the culture around you, always dragging you down. What does culture around you do? Drag you down. to his level of immaturity. God brings the best out of you, develops well-formed maturity in you. Oh man, that's good. We don't want to be drugged down by the culture. We want to understand that our attention and our focus needs to be on God. We fix our eyes on God, knowing that God is our source, knowing that God is our helper. See, in spite of voting, in spite of trying to get people to see that prejudice is wrong, our attention is still on God. We look to God. And let me say something to you. If you are black and you want to see deliverance, you need to look to God. The Bible said God has chosen the poor of this world. What are you? Rich in faith. So listen, think about it. Those of us who prosper in the kingdom, look where we come from. Poverty. We come from, amen, not riches and wealth. God chooses people, amen, from poverty. Look at where Fred Price came from. So poor that, amen, he got his stuff repossessed. His car and other things were repossessed. Amen. Look at Creflo Dollar. So poor that he had to, didn't he have a good pair of shoes, was on welfare. Let me tell you something. But God raises men and women up so he can get the glory. So we know who poor men, black men, and Hispanic people should be looking to in this time. You should be looking to God, calling on God, trusting God with all your heart, not leaning to your own understanding, because there is a system. It's the kingdom of God system that's based on tithing and giving that will bring you to a place of more than enough. I'm here to tell you, I come from the project. Hallelujah. Apartment 81 Eastside Home used to be where I was, amen, raised up at. But I'm telling you, God put my wife and I in a neighborhood. We were the first black people here. Amen. I'm telling you, God is able to give you an abundance of things, an abundance of stuff. Listen at Romans 12 and 2 in the Passion Translation. It says, stop imitating the ideas and opinions of the culture around you, but be inwardly transformed by the Holy Spirit through the total reformation of how you think. This will empower you to discern God's will as you live a beautiful life, satisfying and perfect in his eyes. See, God wants you to live a what kind of life? A beautiful life. But you cannot imitate the ideas and the opinions of the culture around you. You cannot go along with the world system. You cannot go along with the status quo. You got to come out. Come out mentally, come out spiritually, and look to Jesus as the author and the finisher of your faith. Listen at this. Success in the world system deals with what you got. But success in the kingdom of God system deals with who you serve. Hallelujah. That's important. See, it don't matter what you got. What matters is who you serve. Because in the world system, they call success based on what you got. Man, you serving the devil, but they look at you got a nice car, you got a nice house, you got some money in the bank, and they call you successful. But let me tell you something. If you're serving the devil with your nice car, with your nice house, with that money in the bank, you are a failure. And you're going to see in the end that you are a failure. Because you're not putting your trust in God. You got your trust in uncertain riches. And we see how that can be easily wiped out. We see how that something like a pandemic or anything else can wipe out, amen, that little bit of stuff you think you got. You got the trust in God. The Bible speaks of a man who had bonds. And then he got so successful, he wanted to tear the old down and build himself some bigger bones. And the Bible called that man a fool. He said, you fool, this night your soul is required of you. And then he said, so if everyone that is rich in this world and is not laying up treasure in heaven and is not rich toward God. I want to be rich toward God. I know who I serve. And since I serve God, and I honor God, he's going to provide for me and he's going to take care of me. I can cast all my care upon him, for he careth for me. Hallelujah. Psalm 55 and 22 says, cast thy burden upon the Lord, for he shall sustain thee. Glory to God. Listen, the world system judges man's value by his pocketbook and his bank account. But the kingdom of God judges man's value based on the fact that he has been created after the likeness or the similitude of God. Let me say that again. The world system judges man's value based on his pocketbook or his bank account. They say, hey, look, can't do this to him because he got money. He's a success. He got some stuff. But see, then they'll do it to somebody who seems disenfranchised, somebody who seems poor, somebody who seems irrelevant. But we must not let George Floyd's death be in vain. We must not let, amen, Tamir Rice and Trayvon Martin, these people's death be in vain. We must stand up for Ahmaud Arbery and others, amen, and let them know that these men's lives, these people's lives are and were valuable. We recognize, amen, that it's that their lives were valuable. Even Breonna Taylor, who was shot to death, amen, right in her own home. Can you imagine being shot to death in your home? Amen. Being killed in your home, place that you think is safe, a place where you think, amen, I'm okay. Oh, my goodness. Oh, but that's part of that world system. Amen. That don't see that everybody is important. Everybody is valuable because every man and woman you meet has been created in the likeness and image of God. They are a spirit. They have a soul and they live in a body. And that's why no other black should be killing any other black. Amen. Because we as black people, we don't need to be killing each other either. Amen. John 4 and 34 says, Jesus said unto them, my meat is to do the will of him that sent me and to finish his work. See, what's important to the person that's in the kingdom of God is doing the will of God and finishing the work of God. Jesus said, amen, in John 17 and 4, he said, I have glorified thee on the earth. I have finished the work which thou gavest me to do. See, we want to finish the work, the assignment that God gave us to do. Because why? We're in the kingdom of God. John 17 and 4 in the Message Bible says, I have glorified you on earth by completing down to the last detail what you have assigned me to do. Jesus completed down to the last detail everything that the Father assigned him to do. And that's why I want to write these books that God told me to write, because it's an assignment. It's something he's assigned me to do. And what God has assigned you to do, you want to complete it down to the last detail. So you can say like Jesus, it's finished. So you can say like the Apostle Paul, I fought a good fight. I finished my course. Amen. I kept the faith. I finished my course. That's what you want to do. Finish running this race. The world system, watch this now, is a culture that seeks to hijack definition. Let me say it again. You need to write that statement down. The world system is a culture that seeks to hijack definition. What do I mean? In other words, everything that has a definition, amen, the world system will hijack the original definition of it and say, look, that's your truth. I got my truth. That's why they do it. That's what they do with marriage. Marriage, as we know it, according to God's word, is a male and a female. But the world system and the culture around us will hijack that definition and say a man with a man is a marriage. A woman with a woman is a marriage. But that's not biblical definition of a marriage. Again, that's the world system definition. But when you come out of that world system and get God's definition, you'll be in line with God. Listen, the kingdom of God system functions in light of God's definition. With everything, we function in light of God's word thereby getting God's definition. What does God say about same-sex marriage? He calls it an abomination. That's what God says about it. What does God say about premarital sex? He calls it wrong. He calls it fornication. What does God say about, amen, you not tithing, you not giving? God calls you a robber. That's what God says. You are a robber. You are a thief. That's what God called you, a thief. Now, do you want to be called a thief by God, or are you going to say, I'm all right? Oh, if I were you, I would go get connected to a local church and start tithing and giving immediately. Well, I can't afford it. My bill's going to get behind. Let me tell you something. You cannot honor God and your bills get or stay behind. He promised to open up the windows of heaven, pour you out a blessing that there will not be room enough to receive. What happens is you don't stay with the kingdom of God system long enough to see it activated and see it work. You got to stay with it. You got to be committed to it and dedicated to it, and don't switch and go back to the world system. Stay with God's system. You are in the kingdom. And in the kingdom of God, amen, this is how it works. Read Proverbs 3 and 9. It speaks that you are to honor the Lord with your substance. And when you do, he tells you that your bonds will break out with plenty. You will have new wine. You will have the best of life. Oh, let's get into the kingdom of God system. Remember, Matthew 24 and 14 says, and this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached in all the world for a witness unto all nations, and then shall the end come. What gospel should be preached? The gospel of the kingdom of God. We are in the kingdom of God, and the kingdom of God rules over every system. When there's a corrupt jail system, the kingdom of God rules over it. When there's a corrupt educational system, the kingdom of God rules over it. When there's a corrupt money system, the kingdom of God rules over it. When there's a corrupt wisdom system, the kingdom of God rules over everything that's corrupt, everything that's wicked, everything that's evil. The kingdom of God comes and takes charge and takes dominion over it. Period. Hallelujah. That's why years ago when they told us we would never own any property in East Tarboro, we could own some in Princeville, but not in East Tarboro because of the color of my skin. A white man looked me right across the desk and pointed to me and said, Van, I'm sorry. You will never own no property in East Tarboro because of the color of your skin. This white man said, I'll sell you some in Princeville, but not in East Tarboro. But God told me, I have chosen you for the city. I have called you to the city. And guess what today? Today we not only own 1 acre, amen, we own, amen, approximately 12 acres there on Main Street, amen, and then we own 1.4, amen, on Albemarle Avenue. See, when the devil says no, no, there's a system, the kingdom of God system, that rules over the world system. Glory to God. That's based on prejudice and racism and our hatred. You can't change that stuff. The way you overpower it is through the kingdom of God system. Is God raising up righteous men and righteous women, putting them in authority, putting honest people, putting fair people in authority. That's why it's important, sir. If you are born again, spirit-filled, and love God, and you are good in the political arena, you are just as important as me preaching the gospel. You are just as important, amen, as, amen, me standing up here or sitting up here on Facebook Live preaching. If you are born again, spirit-filled, and you love God, and you're good in the educational system, then you are just as important. Use your platform to promote righteousness. Oh, let me get it from, oh, let me go on. Let me see. Let's talk about the kingdom of God system. Number one, we said it is under the control of God Almighty. The kingdom of God system is under the control of God Almighty. Psalms 12, verses 3 and 5. 3 through 5. Every time I try to get in this kingdom of God system, my time run out. Next week, I ain't going to talk about the world system at all. I'm going to just jump to the kingdom of God system, because every time I try to go through this thing, I get caught up in it because I'm trying to help you understand it so you will not function as a child of God functioning in that old system you came out of. Come all the way out of it and function as a child of God, loving God, loving the ways of God, serving God, lifting up the church, that called out group. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Again, this word bless you, you got to go back to previous teaching that I've done on Facebook and on YouTube and hear what we said. All right, listen. Psalms 12, verses 3 through 5 said, the Lord shall cut off all flattering lips. What the Lord going to do? Cut off all flattering lips and the tongue that speaketh proud things. See, because what the Bible says in that world system, the lust of the eyes, the lust of the flesh, and the pride of life. That ain't of the Father. Look how proud people are. I don't need God. I don't need to go to church. I don't need to read my Bible. I don't need to pray. They tired. They want you. All they want is your money. No. You don't understand. We're trying to get you to live in a system that will keep you, amen, broke. Come out of that system and get in a system that wants you to prosper. All right, look at verse 4. Who have said with our tongue, will we prevail? That's how they got so proud. They said, we're going to prevail. Our lips are our own. Our mouth are our own. You can't tell me how to not curse. You know, you ain't got no business cursing and swearing. The Bible said, let no corrupt communication proceed out of your mouth. But you say, our lips are our own. Who is Lord over us? But look at verse 5. This is Psalms 12 and verses 3 through 5. Check out verse 5. For the oppression of the poor, for the sighing of the needy, now will I arise, said the Lord. I will set him in safety from him that puffeth at him. You see who the poor need to be looking to? You see who people really need to be looking to? Black people, let me tell you something. God brought us out of slavery. He raised up people like Dr. Martin Luther King, Harriet Tubman, but God brought us out. God brought us out of the tobacco patches, out of the cotton fields. God did it. Bless you, Frieda Odom. Good to know you're watching today. Amen. So there's a system that's under the control of God Almighty that he said, I will hear the sighing of the poor, hear the oppression of the poor, and I will arise. That's what God did. He said, I'm come down. I'm going to do something about Pharaoh. I'm going to get rid of this Pharaoh. I'm going to put down Pharaoh. And God wiped out Pharaoh and his army through and by the Red Sea, drowned every last one of them. Glory to God. Hallelujah. God knows how to deal with the wicked. Number two, the kingdom of God system is an honest and a sincere system. It is based on righteousness and it is a godly system. See, one thing about it, if you do right, God promised to bless you. Listen at Proverbs 10 and 2 in the American Standard Version. Proverbs 10 and 2 in the American Standard Version says, treasures of wickedness profit nothing, but righteousness delivered from death. What is over in this system we in? Righteousness. So if we do right, we ain't got to worry about nobody. Nobody can stop us in the kingdom of God system when we do right. When we do right, if wrong shows up, it's going to be short-lived. God is going to move out anything wrong. The Bible said it this way. No weapon, formed against you and I shall prosper. The Bible said, in all these things, we are more than conquerors. The Bible says, think it not strange concerning these fiery trials as the trial, though some strange thing happen. But I'm telling you, God will deliver you. Amen. The third thing is that it is controlled or governed by love or unselfishness. The kingdom of God system is controlled and governed by love and unselfishness. Listen at 1 John 4, verses 5 through 8. It said, they are of the world, therefore speak they of the world, and the world heareth them. We are of God. He that knoweth God heareth us. He that is not of God heareth not us. Hereby know we the spirit of truth and the spirit of error. Beloved, let us love one another. For love is of God, and everyone that loveth is born of God and knoweth God. He that loveth not knoweth not God, for God is love. In the kingdom of God, this is a system that's controlled by love and governed by unselfishness. Nobody who's really claiming to know Jesus can be operating in hate. You operate in love and you operate in unselfishness. The Bible said that we are to love our neighbor as ourselves. That's what's in the kingdom of God system. Now, next week, I'm going to pick up right here and I'm going to deal with what is contained in this system and what does this system consist of. And we're going to talk to you about, amen, the things that's in this system, because we have to understand that if we want to see a turnaround in our world in which we live, we need to come out of the world system and function in the kingdom of God system and take the kingdom of God wherever we go. See, if you're saved, you're born again. Every morning, if you go to work and you're a school teacher, you're taking the kingdom of God. If you're a lawyer and you're born again and you're spirit filled and you love Jesus, everywhere you go, what are you taking? The kingdom of God. Hallelujah. So the answer to man's plights and problems in this world is he needs Jesus. You need to be saved, sir. You need to be saved, ma'am. See, when people are saved, they can no longer operate and should no longer operate in hate, no longer operate in preferring one color over another color. You want to be fair to everybody. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Amen. That's what the kingdom of God is all about. And this is the system that God wants men in. He wants you delivered from Satan and come over into the kingdom of God's dear son. I'm glad to be in the kingdom. It's an honor to be in the kingdom. And I'm going to preach this gospel of the kingdom everywhere I go. I pray that you've been blessed by this message. Again, continue to speak up, sir. Continue to speak out against injustice. Jesus, when he walked this earth, the Bible said he came unto his own being a Jewish people, but his own received him not. So we owe it to our race, black or white, to continue to speak up against injustices done to them. And if you are a white person, and if you care about our country, if you care about people, it's time for you to speak up. Be like Apostle Paul, who withstood Peter to his face. He didn't talk about Peter behind his back. He withstood Peter to his face and told Peter, "Peter, you're wrong." Because Peter walked away from the Gentile brothers once those Jewish people came along. And God had already showed him in a vision that what I have cleansed, you don't call common or unclean. Amen. And so we have to understand that this is not a day and time to burn down property, not a day and time to loot, but it is a day and time to speak up and let our voice be heard, amen, against racial injustices, and deal with empowering people and helping them know that there's a God who wants to prosper your life and get the glory for doing it. And God wants to turn all this stuff around if we will call upon him and let him bless you. Again, if these messages are being a blessing to you and you would like to be a blessing to our ministry, I want you to do something for me. I want you to pull up, amen, the Give Plus app. Pull up the Give Plus app. And when you pull up the Give Plus app, type in Newness of Life Christian Center. When you do, you can sow a seed. Or you can type in 27886. When you type in 27886, Newness of Life Christian Center is going to pop up. And when it does, you can be a blessing to our ministry. Be a blessing to what is designed to help you. Amen. In this day and time, amen, you need to be a giver. God loveth a cheerful, prompt to do it giver. Or if you're not into technology that way, you can mail, amen, and write us and sow a seed to our ministry by writing us at P.O. Box 1462. Write to Newness of Life Christian Center, rather. Newness of Life Christian Center, P.O. Box 1462. Tarboro, North Carolina, 27886. Let me give you that address again. You write to Newness of Life Christian Center, P.O. Box 1462, Tarboro, North Carolina, 27886. I want to personally thank All of you givers at Newness of Life Christian Center, you all are giving brilliantly and joyously. And we thank God again that we are continually meeting budget, and we honor God for doing that. Amen. And if you didn't get yours in, don't forget you can use the Give Plus app and type in Newness of Life Christian Center, or you can type in 27886, Newness of Life Christian Center, gonna pop up, and you can be a blessing. Also, if you would just like to be a blessing to my wife and I, you can hit the Cash app and hit that Cash app and hit that dollar sign, and then you can type in R, and then type in the word determined, D-E-T-E-R-M-I-N-E-D. Amen. And we got that taken from this powerful CD that my wife has put together called Determined. It is a great CD. Amen. Again, if you don't have any of our books, we have 10 powerful books. We got a book out. Our latest book is entitled, Where Are Those Miracles? Releasing the Power of God. We also have a book called Spiritual Upgrade. Amen. It's a tremendous book that can be a blessing to you. Amen. Challenging yourself to improve. And we also have a book called Women of Substance, Taking New Steps to New Dimension. Again, if you really want to deal with this situation that's going on in our country, amen, I wrote a book years ago called Sheep Taming Wolves. And in this book called Sheep Taming Wolves, we talk about taking a nonviolent approach to what's going on. And I want you to do that. Understand that Jesus said, behold, I send you forth as sheep in the midst of wolves. So we want to operate like sheep in the midst of wolves. Don't you dare let a wolf turn you into a wolf. Use a nonviolent approach, because that's the approach that Martin Luther King used to change things around. And that's what Jesus said would work. He said, behold, I send you forth as sheep in the midst of wolves. Be ye therefore, amen, wise as serpents, but be harmless as doves. And it ain't being harmless when you burn property down, when you throw stuff, when you throw things at the police force. That is not what we are about. That's not what black men, that's not what white people, that's not what Hispanic people should be about. We should do it peacefully and let God move the hearts and minds of men. Let God do it. Let God work. Vengeance belongs to him, and he knows how to repay. Well, again, until next time, you be blessed of the Lord and give God praise. Call upon the Lord and bless him, because he deserves to be exalted. Come on, give him glory as we end this broadcast today. God bless you is our prayer. Hallelujah. Woo! Get your praise on today. Give him glory. Hallelujah. Woo! Hallelujah. Don't forget, call upon the Lord, for he is worthy to be praised. So shall you be saved from all your enemies, financial enemies, racial enemies. Whatever enemy show up, God will deliver you from them. Hallelujah. Woo! Until next time, you be blessed of the Lord. Hallelujah.